Hi, I start with pouring clear epoxy resin in silicone cups. I will tint it in three colors, blue, green and red. I had leftovers of blue alcohol inks and I wanted my bottle to glow, so I added Lumina 4. Yeah, I'm demonstrating this cute duck-shaped paperclip rather than powder itself. The color was too pale, so as I had nothing but food dye, I added a drop of it. Food dyes are not suitable for resin. You can notice tiny blue bubbles. They don't mix with resin properly. For green color, I wanted to use this dye, because it contained sparkles. It should be liquid actually, but I think it expired. Let's try once again. This time normal dye. No, not yet. Here it is. I totally forgot about it. It is also alcohol inks for battery art. And a bit of Lumina 4. And these sparkles! That was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Here goes red. I don't need you. While air bubbles come out, let's make some more colors. Just some drops of white to make resin translucent. And of course, sparkles. It is nail powder, but you can use eyeshadows or glitter. Here I'm hiding unsuccessful experiments by adding black dye. As if nothing had happened. Look at this gorgeous color. But unfortunately, this dye expired too. Nevertheless, I tried to mix it well, but lumps were still visible, so I thought one drop of black dye would solve this problem. It did indeed. But I didn't use this color. Bottles. Prepare your bottles, wash them if needed and wipe dry. And I start pouring resin. The feeling like I'm doing it for eternity. And here I'm pouring, but it's poured in reverse. And here I'm pouring in four dimensions. Car caps will have eye pins. Mark the middle with a needle.
Middle with a needle.
God knows how it all rhymes. Apply super glue and screw in the pin. Now dip the cap in resin. Remove excess and close the bottle. Clean it if necessary. I roll the bottle like this. But I don't know what for. Also, apply a small drop of resin near the pin. Cork will absorb it and there will be fewer chances that the pin may tear off, because cork is loose material. Here I decided to add clear resin to dilute white color. I thought just black would be boring, so the rest of the space I filled with clear resin. Look at these cuties! In smaller bottles, I put dry flowers. As flowers are fragile, I pour resin inside. I fill bottles gradually, letting the resin to spread. In addition, I wanted to get effect of pickles, so I added drops of red and yellow resin. I correct everything inside and remove some floated petals. And here I remove only this bubble in order not to damage flowers. On aged paper I printed titles, as you can see in several copies. I hope that you know how to age paper with tea or coffee. See, I lighted a candle for your health. Yeah, no bad humor. And a fun part is starting. I almost immediately blow out the flame and extinguish by tapping as the paper continues to smolder. Yes, I do it right on my table. I made several copies to have a choice of the best variant. Then I applied PVA glue to the back side and to the front one too. Before you glue the inscription, choose the side according to the eye pin, like this if you use a jump ring, and like this if you just pass the cord through the pin. I carefully place the paper. I wanted the bottles to hang on different lengths, so I cut chain on pieces of 5, 4 and 6 cm. However, later on I shortened to segments. First, I wanted to open the pin this way. But I noticed it started to tear off the cork cap. so I had to use jump prints. Two for reliability. Of course, it's better to use such prints, but I didn't have necessary color. Yeah, too many rings turned out, but what we have is what we use. Wipe the bottles from dust and the keychain is ready. The other jars I decided to hang with the help of waxed cord, in the case if you don't have pins. I fold a 30cm long cord in half, press it near the loose ends, and put the other end on top. You should get such a pretzel. Then I put one loop on top of the other. Here, in this place, you should get a cross. You need to pass cord through it like this, holding the loose ends. And pull. The cord should be straightened and it will turn out like this. I found this method on Pinterest, so I will leave a link to it, where it is shown more detailed. I cut excess and will fix in such a connector for lace. It is a bit difficult to do from the first time, so I applied super glue. And as additional decorations, I took these beads. I also used two rings for greater reliability. But I don't pass the second ring through the next link, but through one. Finishing touches and it's done!